Okay, everybody. My third deconstruction. I have so much to cover. I have so many notes. I don't understand what any of my notes mean. I just ripped my notes. You hear that crazy sound? Okay, I'm petrified. I'm not going to get this. Okay, so here we go. It's a little salute to Idina Menzel. She's amazing. We're going to start with first Wild Party. Okay, let me get my cue. What I'm first obsessed with is this crazy riff she does. She goes, don't you want to feel those shivering fits till someone calls it quits, till someone calls it... I don't know what calls it... I don't know what the riff is. I literally can't even... I can't even see what the notes are. Or someone... It's not... Or someone calls... It's, or someone calls... you understand? I can't do it. And I'm completely obsessed. Okay, here, listen.
Don't you wanna be
What are those notes? Okay, hold on. It's almost like it's not part of the scale. I don't know what the hell she's singing, but I'm really awesome. Okay, hold on one more time. I'm obsessed. Here we go. Listen.
The life of the party. Ready? Don't you wanna be the cream of the crop? Don't you wanna feel those shivering fits till someone calls it quits or someone calls it
I'm obsessed. Okay, now, part two, what we have to listen to is, I'm obsessed with Andrew Lipa's writing, because he goes into three, let the drinks pour on, it literally goes into 3-4, and I've played this for Adina before, and whenever I play it for him, I'm always like, wait, what? Clankety, clankety, clank. Just the rhythm is crazy, because it goes from 3-4, then into 4-4. Okay, my notes are that it's, oh god, I can't read my own notes. Juggernaut is 3, what? No, right side 120. Okay, wait, this part you're not supposed to listen to. Where's my stage manager? Okay, and cut. 3-4, here we go. Okay, so that, first of all, I'm obsessed with. It goes from 3-4 to 4-4. Then I love the riff on Till the Sunrise. Then she does the signature two-syllable for the word bridge. Brings the good. So I love the till. First of all, it's a scoop on Till. Till the sun. Ba-da-da-da. Very Lilias White, Brotherhood of Man. Spot that deconstruction, just for a callback. So it goes, Till the Sunrise. Brings the... Okay, I'm obsessed with the, dividing one syllable into two. Here we go, one more time.
Let the...
So we're in 3-4.
Let the crowds roar. Let the heavens wildly cheer.
Here we go.
Till the sunrise brings the goodbyes.
I'll be here, never fear. She hits the D straight tone, but then she does have a vibrato to it. Even though she's going to slide up, she could have just gone, never fear. No, but she goes, but never fear. Then she slides up. That's what I'm obsessed with. Here we go. Ready?
Never
fear. See? Gives it a rock. Thank you, Adina.
Never fear. Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be now?
She does a signature separation of one syllable. Don't you want to be for loose and furry? And goes up the octave. She shows what a sassy soprano she is. Obviously, in high school chorus, she was in the Sopranos. Furry, but up the octave, furry. Vocal damage. Okay, hold on one second. Ignore the Britney Spears vocal damage. And hold on one second. Furry. There we go. Okay, now what I love is that she doesn't breathe. She goes, like, and instead of going, like me, she goes, like me. She does not breathe. That's what I'm obsessed with. It's in one breath. She's just sort of, me. You think she's breathing, but she's not. Listen how she connects the m.
Yeah.
that's amazing because it's literally one breath. And then, you know, I don't like fake vowels. So instead of going "may," she goes "me" for 1 second and then goes to a "yeah," which would annoy me if it was in "me," but because she adds the "yeah," I love it. "Me, yeah." Okay, hold on 1 second. One breath. Here we go. Okay, right after the juggernaut, people, I'm running out of time. What a dirty trumpet, that's what we call it in the biz. Okay, so here we go. The first thing, what is my first number? Juggernaut 120. Okay, I'm just obsessed with the lyric that Andrew Lipper wrote. Like, Adina's like, "Hey, why have we ever slept together?" And he's like, "When I met you, you were less than a dirty whore." It's such a rude thing to say to somebody. I'm just obsessed with that. Brian D'Arcy James literally says to Adina's face, "You were less than a dirty whore." Okay, I'm obsessed with that lyric. Here we go.
Won't you tell me first?
And he actually adds vibrato to the word whore. He's insulting her, but he sounds amazing. Less than a dirty whore. Okay, hold on. I'm obsessed with that lyric. Here we go. End play.
It don't bother me.
I'm just asking why.
When we met, you were less than a dirty whore.
Yes, but that was before I...
Okay, and as usual, what does she do? Separates "before I got smart." Two syllables. Smart. I'm obsessed with the two-syllable, one-syllable words. Here we go.
Don't bother me.
I'm just asking why.
When we met, you were less than a dirty whore.
Yes, but that was before I got smart. Now my whoring has turned into whore.
Amazing. Then Andrew Lipper does this crazy, the most amazing a cappella harmony that's in 3/4. Where Adina's holding that, everyone's doing these chords underneath her. She straight tones, then she vibratos, then she does a crazy riff, and it's in 3/4. It's just so creative. Now, where the F is it? It's at 3:30. Do you want, right? 3:30. Okay, hold on. People, where's my stage manager? Okay, hold on.
One hand, one step, one touch, one hand, and here we do.
Crazy riff. Okay, what's happening? It is so crazy creative. Plus, then it goes into 7. That's right, it goes into 7. Hold on, listen to the amazing Andrew Lipa amazingness. Hold on, one more time. Straight tone, vibrato, then crazy riff. It's also tip of the hat to Dina's bar mitzvah, because it's a little bit of Sephardic. Oh, baruch ata. Okay, here, listen. Seven. Okay, I don't know what the counting is, but it's amazing. Okay, final thing. Wizard and I, people. Now, two things I'm going to play for you. Wizard and I, what is my first notation? Okay, 3:35. So this is Wizard and I, obviously from Wicked. Hold on.
Oh, Miss Elphaba.
Okay, first of all, must it begin with the, oh, Miss Elphaba? Couldn't they have just started a film? Did this really just happen? Did I really need to hear the whole carousel at the beginning? Couldn't it be on a separate track? Honestly. Okay, where was I? 3:35, I think is what it is. Okay, so I want you to listen to this, and then I'll tell you what Stephen Schwartz told me, which I think is so phenomenally cool. Okay, here we go. Okay, so Stephen Schwartz told me that he did so many tips of the hat to the Wizard of Oz movie. Do you know that? Sorry about that. Do you know that that's literally, that's my phone. Do you know that that's literally Somewhere Over the Rainbow? Somewhere over the rainbow, unlimited my future. Somewhere over the rainbow, unlimited. Listen to it again. Isn't that cool? Bravo, Stephen Schwartz.
Our pair will be the wizard and...
Here we go.
Somewhere over the
rainbow.
Thank
you. Okay, and the final thing I want to do is show Adina's sassy technique at the end. I'm very fascinated with this, but she literally adds an L. I think it's because she doesn't want to do a glottal on wizard and I. She doesn't want to grip her throat. So she literally does an L. She goes, the wizard and lie. Because I think, and I, like grips, it's called the glottal. And I think she doesn't want to do it. So she literally adds an L, which I'm obsessed with. And she does it on the recording. But don't dish her because she straight tones right at the end, adds delicious vibrato. Okay, here we go. The final ending. What was I?
When people see me, they will scream.
What's that?
For half of us is favorite team.
Ready to go. That's an L. One more time, one more time, one more time. Hello. Here we go, here we go, here we go.
The wizard.
Ready?
Hello.
Straight tone.